So, back inside the tavern. Now those unpleasant individuals have left. Marlo has cleaned up her own bleed. and you guys are all sitting there. I noticed Kia has moved back over to the person that she talked to a little earlier. The guy that warned you to get away from those people. But too late. Well, he really didn't warn you too late. It just, they didn't react.
I invite them to join us for a drink now that the tribesmen are gone. Just to get to know.
Also, we've got some shutters, haven't we? Let me undo the shutters. Poof, poof, poof. There we go. We're back. Okay. Right, so you invite them to, you want to invite them to sit?
Pull up chairs at our table or vice versa.
He kind of looks at the other two and they're like, he says, suit yourself.
Cool.
I will.
Awesome.
This fellow comes over and pulls up a chair and sits right here at the head of your table. He turns the chair around and sits on it backwards. So like the, you know, he's actually, so he's resting his arms on the top of the chair. He's like, evening all.
Evening.
Well, that was a bit of unfortunate mishap. I do apologize that, I guess your friend didn't hear me.
Well, it was a noble thing you tried to do to, you know, keep the peace.
Hey,
Astar.
If she would have hit him back, it would have probably turned into a bloodbath in here. So I just wanted to avoid that.
Well, she is quite the fighter.
Yeah.
Might not look it, but she can surprise you.
Well, tell us, how strong are those tribal men? And is that the average strength there, that guy we saw?
I wouldn't say average. I would say he is probably one of the bigger and more brutal I've ever seen. Mm. But that's, as I said, the Harn's Plain tribe are not usually that aggressive. See, what I overheard was, as I said, apparently they're outcasts. Not entirely sure why I didn't get all the information, but the huge, big, brutish one, I believe, has intentions of taking him and his friends and, attempting to join a different tribe. If that happens, I shudder to think what's going to happen to this region.
Oh, like a war of sorts I can... You
probably
speak
tribal of? Wars, yeah. You got to think about it. If a disgruntled Harnsman joins the Scarbloods with all the information that he could possibly provide the Scarbloods about the Harnsmen, they'll probably butcher him.
And innocent towns like this will probably be in the wake of that carnage.
It's possible. Of course, it's all north, you know, northeastward of here, but the Harns, see, the Harn Plainsmen, they're pretty, I wouldn't say they're placid. Don't get me wrong, they're still tribal and they're still very suspicious and can be a little bit heavy-handed, but they're not wantonly bloodthirsty or warlike. The Scarbloods, on the other hand, well, they butcher their victims, they crucify them, they rip out their entrails, anything disgusting and gory, that's their MO.
And is slavery common in the tribal lands? Even with the Harns Plains people?
I've never known the Harns Plains folk to be slavers, no.
So that lady in chains was an exception.
Well, again, outcasts. Hmm. Who knows why they're outcast?
He
said, the biggest concern is whether or not that woman was a Harrier or not.
A what?
Oh, a Harrier. They're a tribe to the west. All women. All of them.
That's what my question was, actually. That's the third tribe?
Yes.
They're all women?
Pretty much. Like a Amazonian kind of tribe, if you were. They have a few men, but the men are subservient.
And are they hostile?
Generally speaking, to men, yes. they're very territorial. But they would take great offense should they know that one of their kind had been enslaved.
Mm-hmm.
And
but I don't know for a fact that that is what she was.
Is there any reason why someone maybe far to the south of here, maybe in the capital, would not want that tribal name uttered?
Don't know.
See, we...
Could well be a reason, but I wouldn't know what it was.
Well, my wife and I hail from Saruman.
Oh, you're a wife. You're married, are you?
Yes, I hooked this lovely lass in the mountains of Epitamon. Tri-Crown Mountains. Wow.
Couldn't resist that face.
Well, I suppose if I was stuck up in the mountains all by myself, I'd latch onto just about anything myself, so... makes sense.
Well, you see... Nope. Oh, go ahead,
I'm
dear.
I'm just going to pretend like I didn't hear that. Honey.
Okay, Marlo, what are you doing once you've cleaned your mess?
Sorry, I remembered I muted my mic.
That's all right.
Marlo is standing there in a drunken daze, staring at where she got hit.
Okay, trying to fathom out how did that happen, I guess, or what happened. Okay. Racer, you're just sitting there quiet at this point, I guess?
Deathly quiet, just listening to everything.
Okay.
Well, trying not to be noticed, actually. Even though I'm right there.
As I was saying, sir, what's your name again? Sorry, my wife didn't tell me.
Your wife didn't tell you?
Your name.
You're not very polite, are you, my dear?
Oh, no.
My name is Roger, sir.
Roger. Well, my name is Radovan Rainier.
Yes, Roger. Yes.
Roger, Radovan, Rainier. A lot of R's about all of a sudden.
Oh, Kia, channel your inner Marlo. That dude is being sexist. Punch him in the face.
So,
not very polite, are you, my dear?
We came across a strange traveler. See, we're in merchandising. I'm a traveling. I try to sell.
Oh, really? What do you trade?
All sorts of things. Saruman is just a virgin enterprise of a town. Stone quarry nearby. Metals. You know, we've been trading with Korthan, mostly.
Also, a giant tower for sale over there.
It's near Korthan?
South of Korthan, yes.
Jesus, you're a long, long, long way away from home. What on earth would you want to come all the way up here to trade for? Surely there's places closer that you could trade with.
Well, they are, but this is... We're newlyweds, you see, and this is kind of a honeymoon of sorts.
I wanted to see...
Of all the places you could come, this is not where I would have chose, that's for sure.
Well, he has a strange attraction to strange locations. I couldn't help it. What was I to do? Look at her, you know?
Well, I can understand, I suppose.
Things, yes.
Personally, I'm involved in wine.
Oh.
I'm traveling around looking for different... Going more to the south to try to find some more exotic and more fragrant and flavorful grapes.
Well, there are some grapes out west.
Oh, how many?
Like two or three. You see, there Saruman had there's a Fields of Sorrow farther to the west, and we're trying to pump it up and make it like harvestable, salvageable land, you know? So grapes is one of the things we've been trying to spruce.
Well, we could definitely... I could definitely sell you, an adequate crop to plant a decent vineyard if the ground and the territory is suitable.
It's not quite suitable yet.
Oh, well...
I've been hollowing it out, you know, it's still kind of has some undead creatures.
Did you just bump into that poor guy sitting at that chair?
Just a little bit.
He staggers and stuff. The guy's like, hang on a second.
Drunk Marlo is drunk.
She's staggering all across the tavern.
I shouldn't have given her that sake.
Yeah.
So, but yeah, just pretty much, is there any... How's the places around here? Like to the north, northeast? I mean...
Well, I mean, obviously you can go south, and well, you've been south, but north of here, if you take the main northern road directly through the mountains, I mean, that's going to lead you, well, very different type of territory. To be honest, I don't travel that far north myself. Not good grape-growing country anyway. To the east? If you follow the eastern road, you will travel round and eventually skirt the mountains. A lot of people prefer that, say it's safer, even though it is a less direct route. But, you know, you're getting very close to Scarblood territory. Now, recently, I will honestly say that they've never really given any merchants or traders a lot of bother. That being said, Merchant Caravan was attacked by Scarbloods only last week.
Really?
In what way?
How?
Why?
How? Don't really have the details. They just seized a set upon them, butchered them all, and, apparently... some other merchants found them, their wagon burnt, anything of non-interest scattered to the nine winds, and all the corpses had been basically nailed to the wagon wheels and eviscerated.
Oh. That doesn't sound pleasant.
Three men, one woman, and a small boy, I think, was all I heard.
What?
Mm-hmm. As I said, they've never really bothered merchants and such before. I mean, obviously, we've always been very weary, but far enough away from the main road. That's the reason that, you know, the road goes where it does. It skirts all the way around the forest, wide enough normally to be well clear.
I just gotta know, does a guy not notice Marlowe standing in front of him kind of like this?
He's kind of looking at her, but, you know, he's kind of looking at her and just talking to you guys. I mean, she's very, very drunk and not wearing a whole lot. So, very hard to not pay attention. But he isn't being, like, noticeably disrespectful or anything like that. I mean, he's just more jollily smiling and grinning at her than anything else.
Do you think it's funny?
No, I just like the fact that you're having a good time.
A good time?
Marlo?
I just got disrespected over there and lost my honor.
I do apologize. I tried very hard to warn you. And not to beseech your honor in any way, shape, or form, but as skilled a combatant as I think you possibly and probably are, noticing with the company that you keep, I have no doubt in my mind that monster would have ripped you to pieces in less than 10 seconds if you would have been foolish enough to go and mess with him. As I said, no disrespect at all, but he is...
I can never go home now.
Of course you can. Just don't tell anybody. Nobody knows. I didn't even see it. Didn't even pay attention to it, my dear.
Of course. It doesn't matter to any of you.
Oh, Marlo... please sit down.
Yes, Marlo. I suggest that you stop talking for the rest of the night, aka suggest, aka
cast a spell,
suggest,
aka need a saving throw. Okay, so Kia is casting a suggestion spell. Let me go ahead and tell you what you need to write. Everyone's casting spells around Marlo. Poor Marlo. Y'all are mean to her. You should have let her get herself killed. Should have been happier.
No, we're not mean. We're just trying to help her from herself.
She'd have been a lot happier.
Save her from her own self.
Yeah.
Because we care.
No, I care. I do care.
We love Marlo.
Radovan cares a moderate amount. All right, so it's a willpower
really
save. You're going to be looking at a...
Oh, well, let me put me back over here then.
Yeah, we'll
find...
Well, it's not going to stop you going over there. It'll just, if she's successful, you just won't say anything for...
the rest of the night.
11 hours, so yeah, the rest of the night.
Jeez. Is it not nighttime? I forgot.
No, we're still in, like, the day.
Yeah, it's still, like, mid-afternoon.
Shit.
No, mid-afternoon. Sorry, mid-morning.
Well, I said it already, so...
That's okay. Alright, yeah, you're looking at a 17.
Willpower save?
Yep.
What? This is where she rolls, like, fantastically well.
Yeah.
Not this time. Okay, you know what? It was not an... considering your drunken state, not talking to anybody did not seem like an unreasonable thing to you, and you just, like, come up with the idea all by yourself. You know what? That's a good idea. Screw you guys.
Alright, so if I can't say anything, Marlo's just gonna...
You won't... Well, here's the thing. If somebody talks... If somebody talks to you... And it elicits a response, you in theory still could. But you won't just do so on your own accord, basically.
Okay.
Marlo gestures.
Yeah, I... Make sure that they all see. And then I'm gonna walk off.
Alrighty.
Stumble.
Yeah, I'm gonna stumble off. Probably to a guy in the blue again and apologize.
Staggered over to the chair or to the table where your villainous friend...
No, Marlo's just going to climb on top of the table and fall asleep.
Okay, like... Ugh, drooling in her own vomit.
Roger, I do apologize for...
Yes, we have been tasked with taking care
Let's see. While you guys are there, everybody make a spot check for me, please.
Hold on, say it. Wait, hold on.
Except for Ikea, because she's not there. She gets up and leaves.
Ooh, I almost rolled a one.
Okay.
18.
All right. Yep.
Do we still have access to Kia's sheets? No.
Okay. No, I do. Oh, she's back. Okay, go ahead and make a dice roll, please. Okay, all of you definitely noticed. All right, so when Marlo got punched, basically her, like, lip was split, her jaw was, like, really badly swollen, and there was quite a gash where that thing, like, ripped across the side of her face. Mm-hmm. It isn't there anymore. Other than a slight kind of reddish stain where the blood was, there's no cut, no bruise, nothing. She is 100% healed.
Hmm. So, well, see, here's the thing. Radovan would think that she did her, like, little monk trick,
do
right?
You... I don't know how many of you know that she can actually do that.
Haven't we seen her heal from damage that we...
You've seen her in the thick of combat where she's been badly beaten up, heal up some hit points, but never to the extent where everything's completely gone, I don't think.
Okay, so that would be strange since I did not heal her.
Noted, but not saying anything right now.
Yep.
Yeah, like, I'm too distracted. I mean, I notice it, but I'm too distracted by the fact that she's belligerent and... Flipped me the bird.
She's off a rocker.
Oh, if Marlo dies, this sucks. Sorry, Spoon.
If she dies, she dies.
No, so yeah, noted. But
she
I'm
dies
not say
with
anything.
Her honor lost, guys.
Oh no!
That is like the worst way for her to die.
All right. So I apologize, Roger, for that. She doesn't like to back down from fights. And believe it or not, she probably would be quite the challenge to that man. That beast of a man.
Maybe.
She's the champion of the Colosseum in Iridian.
Well, he probably just got lucky and sucker punched her then.
Right.
Probably.
Has there been any wars here recently? Or any wanton slaughter?
No.
Or besides the poor souls out to the east? The caravan?
Poor souls to the east. Oh, the merchants.
The traders. Yeah, the merchants.
Not really. As I said, I mean, sometimes merchants will attempt to trade with the tribesmen. They don't live in the most hospitable places. Sometimes bad things happen to them. But at the end of the day, it's a danger of doing business. If you want to deal with those kind of people... Well, you know, but, I mean, nothing specifically out of the ordinary, no.
So no strange people passing through Rockhelm?
Well, a lot of people have left Rockhelm.
For what reason?
Well, mostly because of what happened at Istardan.
Yes, what did happen at Istardan?
Well, I haven't seen it firsthand, but I heard that the whole town was butchered. Everybody was slaughtered. Personally, I think it was those bastard Scarbloods that did it. After all, it's not that far north from their territory. All it would have taken is somebody from a starting to somehow wrong them and make them call a blood oath out against the town, and the next thing you know, they're all on warpath. I mean, Astarden had a militia, I suppose about 30-plus men, I don't know, but they wouldn't have been no match for an entire tribe of bloodthirsty savages like the Scarbloods.
And Astarden is how far from here? Like, if we were to take the East Road?
East Road?
Or the North Road and then head east? North. I'm sorry, am I...
Well, it really... Either way, I mean... Depends on which way you want to go. I suppose as the crow flies, probably about a week. If you take the eastern road, probably about a week and a half, almost 2 weeks. But you're going to go an awful long way out of your way, as it were. But I certainly, even though it's considerably quicker, if you're going to travel directly northeast, you're going to be traveling straight through the Harn Plains territory, right in through the forest and skirting along the edge of the mountains, getting unpleasantly close to the Scarblood's territory. But there are guides around that you could probably hire that would be willing to take you there.
Any that you would recommend or suggest?
Not really. I'm not the sort of person to wish ill on anybody.
Well, what do you do here?
As I told you, I'm a trader. I just happen to be traveling.
Well, what do you trade? That's what I mean. What do you trade?
Normal, as I say, wine.
That's right.
Wine. I have a vineyard.
Sorry. I blanked there for a second.
I have a vineyard have a vineyard far to the east, and I'm traveling westward looking for new grapes and,
got it.
New ingredients to come up with new delicious beverages.
And your acquaintances over there, are they of the similar trade?
No, Hemdel. He's actually a cartwright. That's how I know him. I often have purchased good, sturdy wagons and carts from him. He said, and Horatio. He said, Horatio, he's what you might call a connoisseur of fine art.
Oh. Well, then I highly suggest he checks out Satchmo's shop in Corfan.
Well, I'll suggest it to him then.
Some great artwork there.
Including pictures of me. No. Everybody should have a Radovan on their wall.
Yeah,
Radovan and the Kia with the enigmatic smile.
Thank you, Roger. You've been quite informative.
Well, I appreciate the fine beverages.
You're very welcome.
And may I suggest that you sample one or two glasses of wine before you leave that this establishment serves?
Sure. I mean, my friends will.
He says, on me. Let me take care of this little treat. I think your friend over there might, probably best leave her alone. I think she's sleeping off a couple of bottles of something heavy already. Mm-hmm. He says, one moment. And he gets up and heads over to the innkeeper. And he comes back carrying four glasses and two bottles of wine. One white, one red. Sits the glasses down in front of everybody. And he says, now then. As he opens up the red wine first. He said, the label on this one, he said, this is a 7-year-old vintage. He says, I call this one Vanderisho. And he kind of pops open the cork and tips you a glass each. He said, it has a strong, fragrant blackberry note to it.
I'm afraid I'll have to take his. My husband's allergic.
Oh, I do apologize. And he kind of pulls the glass away from you. But he puts it in his mouth and does that. He goes, if you'll notice the fruity aroma...
I'll take one sip and look around very impatiently.
And he kind of swallows it. He says, of course, proper wine tasting, you would spit it out, but fuck wasting it.
yes, this is
very
nice. Very nice.
He says, and this white one, he said, you'll notice that this has got a strange kind of sappy flavor to it. He said, I
Marlo?
Mature this one in fine Marlo? Pine barrels.
Okay, get up and walk away.
Poor old Bill, thank you for the donation. We'll give you a proper thank you here in a minute.
So I'm like nodding and appropriately. Oh,
like whatever. Because, it's fucking wine.
So okay,
right, Marlo. Yeah. So when you go over there, and Marlo is probably passed out, fast asleep.
I'm gonna lean over and take a look at her busted lip, which is busted no more.
Okay. There's some dried blood there, but no wound whatsoever.
Weird. I'm just glad to be out of that guy's hair, that's for sure.
Wine isn't real alcohol, right? Gore wine isn't mouthwash. Go to a wine tasting.
Marlo has poor sleep posture. You know, it's like she snores and she scratches herself a lot.
She's like Kung Fu Panda, literally.
I'm just going to take a seat near her so I don't have to be near the other guy now.
Okay.
Roger.
Roger. Alright. He says, well, I hope you enjoy that. I'll finish the bottle by all means.
Thank you.
He says, they're both from my vineyard. Well, I guess you probably figured that out. Anyway, I've got to be off early in the morning, so if you don't mind, I'm going to retire. I've got a couple of things I need to take care of up in my room, and then I'm going to go and check out the marketplace.
Thank you.
Is there any religious establishment here?
Oh, no.
So none of that. And anyone else that you reckon I should talk to just for further information about the surroundings?
Well, I definitely would suggest the marketplace. That's where the majority of traders are going to be, and most of the traders are non-residents here.
Okay, thank you very much.
Oh, and just so you know, it's very reasonable to purchase a table or lease a table for the day if you do have any wares you wish to sell.
Is there happen to be a historical building that keeps records on things?
No, nothing like that, no.
Well, have a good day and good luck on your journeys.
I appreciate it. Thank you very much. And he heads off up these stairs here to the side.
Why'd Keen leave?
I have no idea. I thought you would know. She just was up and out, and I mean, you're closer to her. She took you off and, you know, made you invisible. Or, apparently. I actually didn't see it.
Yeah, didn't she tell you? She'd been practicing a new spell.
She doesn't tell me things.
You guys are married.
She's been so distant lately.
I think she's seeing another cleric. One of them bastards from Pelor.
She can her invisibility spell doesn't break when I attack now.
Oh, well that was actually kind of thoughtful of her. Not gonna lie.
She was pretty excited. You know Kia and her
impetuous. Yeah. Well, what do you think, Raisa? What should our next action be? I mean, we got a dishonored monk, apparently. And, yeah. My wife is doing whatever she does.
Well, Radovan, honestly, sometimes I think we're the only two who think about anything. But you have to make a decision. And it's a hard one.
Well, we could go to the marketplace. Eavesdrop on people. Well, but, no. I mean, it doesn't...
I mean regarding Marlo.
Oh, well, Marlo just needs a wake-up call from the south. That's what she needs.
But we're asking her to change who she is. And
I've changed who I am quite a bit. People change. It's not
people
like...
change.
It's not a horrible thing to change. I don't know why,
but
it's such a stigma.
Asking her to dishonor her entire being. That's a difference.
She got dishonored by being punched out by a dude she was staring down.
Hey, I don't understand it. I don't care to understand it, but I'm just raising the point. We have to make a decision. Are we going to support her, or are we going to tell her she needs to...
Well, I will say this. the prospect of tribal people going to war by outcasts who are clearly assholes and deserve to be brought into the law, not something I'm looking forward to, especially with what that guy said was accurate. And these tribes are just going to go to war if one set of outcasts joins the other set, right? I mean, imagine the innocent people on the roads who can be affected by this. But then again, it's not the war that we're looking for, you know? We're looking for another
war. This is not the war you're looking for.
These aren't the droids we're looking for. So I'm torn. I mean, you saw that lady in chains. I mean, that's... What if all three of the tribes decide to go at it, you know, in this location, in this area? I mean, if she truly was from that woman tribe to the west, and they found out about it...
But that's not our mission.
That isn't our mission. But it is war regardless, right? I mean, war is war. We don't want war. But it isn't our mission. You're right.
What is it good for?
Absolutely nothing.
Go, yo.
Say it again.
So, I'm at a loss. I don't like the fact that there's a lady in chains. I obviously didn't respond because of what happened to Marlo and the fact that our mission is specific to the Jakari or the Jakar or whatever the hell those creatures are.
I just think moving forward, we need to make it clear what our intentions are, because I will not put up with a situation like that again, where it endangers our mission and we have to make, you know, brutal calls like that.
Okay, so what do you want to do about Marlo? She feels dishonored, and she feels neglected, and apparently we don't understand her, which I guess is kind of true. I mean, we didn't grow up in her culture where she grew up. So how are we going to get her feeling right again?
I say we tell her our view on it and let her decide.
Okay, she'll probably want to try to seek those guys out.
And I know she will. Maybe we could offer her the same thing we offered Kia. With Rochek.
But they're not marauding... they are. They're not running around... Well, they kind of are. Oh my god. I mean...
They kind of are.
Rochek and the orcs were different. They were butchering people...
But
on some fucked up conquest
of theirs. You're looking too far into it, Radovan. It was important to Kia, and we pledged to help her. And that's all that matters.
Yeah, but we had a personal stake in that.
No.
We don't. Marlo does. You see how that's different?
You have to make a choice. Is she a friend or not?
Of course she's a friend.
We don't have to decide tonight. It's a complex thing, but I'm just saying, I think for the betterment of all of us, we need to decide what the priorities are. Because if we're going to fail in this mission, it doesn't look good on us, and it's not what I pledged to do.
Right. Gore chuckling over there, man.
So chat's on a roll.
I'm not even looking at chat right now.
I'm having to keep one eye on it because of things earlier.
All right, so we're still in the early day. I mean, maybe you can see about those band of assholes that left, maybe see where they went, get a sense. Mm-hmm. Obviously, don't be seen by them, but you being talented as you are, just track them or something. We'll put Marlo in her room so she can sleep off her drunkenness. And I guess Kia and I could go to the marketplace. I mean, that's an idea.
Do a little honeymoon shopping?
Yeah, honeymoon shopping.
Go find that ring?
Well,
I'll meet you in the marketplace then?
Meet us in the marketplace. And I'll leave a note for Marlo whenever she wakes up.
She can't read then, though.
Wait, what?
You didn't know that?
No.
Don't you listen?
Not when I have my wife nagging in my ears. I'm sorry. There's a lot to keep up on with you guys. You're all very complicated women. I'm just a simple man, all right? It's difficult for me. All right,
can't
so
you
I'll
do your whisper mind thingy.
Well, I could, but I had that reserved for the vizier, and I already sent one to Perellian earlier today. You know, buddy, buddy, wizard that he is. Okay. Well, sure. Let's.
Marlo can read simple words.
She's not a She's not.
Well,
completely
I think
Raisa's illiterate,
only ever
but...
heard her say that she's illiterate. So I don't know if Raisa knows the.
Oh yeah, Marlo can read simple words, but she did say in chorus she couldn't read. That was more because she was trying to be.
Yeah, but as far as you know, that is correct.
Mm-hmm.
Acid Goblin, thanks for the follow, bud.
All right. Did any of us get a room here? All right, I guess I can. We'll put Marlo in it. Maybe, yeah.
Get a room and put Marlo in it. Okay.
You know, Radovan's going to put her in a bed. Make her feel very weird.
When she wakes up and realizes, she'll know. Yeah, she'll know how she got there.
Completely destroying my way of life.
That's
but
it.
Maybe she'll find unseen, untapped pleasure.
Next thing you know, you're gonna make her dress up in like pants and friggin' wear an actual dress.
Radovan's gonna make her eat.
Braid her hair, put her in a dress, put makeup on her.
Put a strip of bacon across your nose. Yeah. All right, I'm gonna go to the barkeep.
All right, 6 silver a night for a room.
All right. Pay 7 silver and say thank you.
Alright.
And then I'm going to head over to Kia.
Oh, hey, Radovan.
Alright, you and I, we're going to the marketplace as husband and wife. Raisa is going to try to track down those assholes that, you know, dishonored Marlo. And then I'm going, without saying anything else, I'm just going to scoop up Marlo in my arms.
Her lip, Radovan, look at it.
Yeah, it's... Well, it's red.
It's completely healed.
All right. Well, I'm gonna go to the room. I'll look into it. Okay.
Okay.
I'm gonna take
so
her
you,
up to the room.
You carry Marlo and put a layer in a bed. Okay.
And I'm gonna do a heal check on her.
All right. Go ahead. That's where he rolls a 1 and causes some damage.
Alright, so 16.
Yeah, there's not a damn thing wrong with her. It's like, not even any superficial bruising. She is 100% as if the blow never happened.
Alright, well then I'm going to do a cantrip. Since you said it was red, right? It was like red and irritated?
No, it's red because there's still some dried blood there, but that's it.
But
the wound underneath,
away.
Okay, then there's nothing there at all.
Then I'm going to say, Deprehendere venomum, and I'm going to do detect poison.
Okay. There is no poison that you can tell other than alcohol. There's a lot of alcohol in her system. But beyond that, nothing else.
I can't really just... Well, flame striker, no. Okay.
Flames.
I am still clothed. I'm not doing anything pervy or weird.
Thanks for her, like... bringing that to everybody's attention.
Well, I have to, because chat would probably pick up on it anyway. I'm going to lay her in bed and cover her in the covers and put the pillows in a very comfortable place around her head. And I'm going to say, you're gonna like that bed. And then I'm just going to back out of the room and close the door.
Okay. All right. Okay, so while you're doing it, Raisa, you were heading outside. You wanted to see if you could figure out where those people went.
Yes.
Those tribal fellows. And their female slave. Okay, how do you wish to achieve this? It's been long enough to that they're not visible on the streets. Sorry, say that once more.
Tracking, do you have to use your survivor skill or there's an actual like thing?
If you have the tracking trait, you would use your survival skill to do it.
Okay, so that is not something I have.
Yeah, no, you don't have tracking.
No.
But there are plenty of people on the streets, and these individuals would not be hard for anybody to have remembered seeing. That's pretty obvious. A 7'6" guy. Sometimes, sometimes it happens.
Who's no, I can't do this. Somebody sign me up for the wrong job. Okay, so I will look for maybe like a lone woman around my age, you know, somebody who doesn't look too terribly intimidating.
Okay. Doesn't take you long at all. You see a woman walking. Basically, there's a well right here. And you see a woman carrying a couple of buckets of water on her shoulders on a long pole, walking across the main street right here, heading towards this house.
So, excuse me, ma'am.
Oh, hello.
I'm sorry to bother you. I was just wondering if you happen to see a group of about four tribesmen and somebody on a chain, and the one gentleman was very big.
Oh, I saw him, yep.
Do you happen to know which way they went?
I certainly do. Thank the Lord they were leaving out of the western or eastern gates. We're heading in that direction anyway.
Oh, thank you. That's what I wanted to hear.
Oh, us too. We really don't like it when the tribesmen come. They rarely do, but that particular group we've seen two or three times over this last 4 or 5 days.
Really? They're
they keep coming back here. I don't know why.
Well, thank you. And I am a visiting town. Could you point me in the direction of your market, please?
Oh, absolutely. It's right there. And she points at this building here.
Oh, well, thank you. Thank you for your time.
I appreciate your pleasantries. Have a good day, my dear, and enjoy Rockhelm. I will tell you that it's not as pleasant as it normally is. A little quiet around here. A lot of people have left with the... You know about the unpleasant trees to the northeast, do you?
No, I just got to town.
Oh, there's a proper town. Well, there was a proper town. It started, unfortunately, several weeks back. Apparently, everybody was murdered.
Are we safe?
The great are good.
Well, don't know. Hard to tell. I mean, we're in a big walled city here, but... Well, I say city. It's more of a outpost, really, but
do you know who murdered them?
Oh no, I've heard rumors. Of course, some people say it's tribesmen. Other people say it's monsters from the mountains, and that Estarden should have been placed in a more suitable place, further away from the edge of the mountains.
Do you know if anyone is investigating this?
I don't know about investigating is the word. More of a rumor mill, really. People traveling north and along the eastern roads just come back with tales.
Oh my, oh, that is
Of course,
scary.
Rumor mill is not very reliable.
This is true. Well, thank you anyways.
Like, for example,
going north.
A lot of the crackpots around here, they said that, you know, them big rocks in the far western, the far southwestern corner of the town. There's a bunch of loonies around here that said that's something to do with wizards and magic and stuff. Of course, all it really is a bunch of big old rocks.
That is weird.
Anyway, enjoy yourself, and yeah, definitely check out the market. Oh, they got some lovely fish this morning. Fresh.
Oh, okay. Well, thank you.
Oh, good day. And she kind of attempts to do a half curtsy, but obviously can't get down too low because she's got all that weight on her shoulders, and then she continues off down the street. She would wave, but she really can't, holding a pole like this. She just kind of smiles and nods. Alright, about this time, I suppose Kia and Radovan will be leaving the establishment, and you would be heading in that direction, probably, if you're going to the market. Assuming you asked somebody where the market was.
We did ask someone where the market was. I imagine Kia did.
That would be pretty obvious.
yes, we would be linked arm in arm.
Aww. Someone draw that. Or Satchmo when you need him, right? Put Jess on the case.
And they're both probably trying to lead the other.
Awkwardly stumbling down the...
Walking out of sync.
Yeah, not that it would be weird at all to see a 6'4" armor-clad priest with a little 5'2" or 5'3" or five... I don't know exactly how tall Kia is. Not very tall.
5'4".
5'4", yeah, there you go. They're definitely... But it's fairly commonplace. You see great big tall guys with little tiny girls. It's obvious. So, alright, you can see Racer kind of just waving at somebody as they go walking off.
You're not waving at me. It's like walking down the street, see someone wave, you're like, oh.
And then they walk straight by you.
That asshole.
Did you make a friend, Raisa?
A local. The tribesmen left town.
Hmm.
Oh, they did. Good.
But she did mention they'd been, you know, back in town about 4 times in the past little bit. She also confirmed the rumors of the slaughter to the north. I tried to get more info out of her, but she just rumor mill. She doesn't know anything.
I wonder if they're going to stay on the road or if they're just going to go into Scarblood country. What do you want to do, Raisa? Do you want to just go in the marketplace with us, or do you want to...
But is there a point to following them, or should we just wait till they come back into town?
Well, what if they don't come back into town and they go to their people, or their new people, and next thing you know, we got war?
What are we going to do about it anyways?
That's true. Barlow's still passed out in bed. I put her in the bed. So maybe she'll, you know,
that'll
realize...
Freak her out.
She'll
That's
have
the
a small
meltdown. Only way to be sure, Skinner.
When she wakes up.
Maybe she'll...
Yeah, but I mean, think of the other options, just to go somewhere out in the wilderness and just throw her down. She'd wake up, what happened?
Alright, well, come to the market with us then. You know, you'll be your friend from the south or something.
From the south.
Our southern friend. You should be ordering biscuits and gravy and all kinds of stuff.
Y'all.
That's it. Alright, let's take you to the marketplace.
Well, that happens every inn you go into. You have to ask for iced tea, but it's got to be sweet tea, and nobody's going to have it up north.
That's right, yeah.
That's a real problem.
And you're going to be pissed because you can't get a drink, and everything's, you know, if you ask for an ale, they're going to ask, you know, they're just going to automatically bring you one particular thing. They're never going to give you a variety choice.
Imagine your surprise when iced tea is sweet tea, and you ask for iced tea, and you get something weird.
Right? Yes.
Canada problems.
Canada problems. Canada is a real word. I knew it. All right.
Okay, of course, yep. Gore's got a market map. Come on, people.
If there's a possibility they're going there, I have a map for it. We have maps for everything. What we don't have is the ability to find a sound effect that I know is on my list.
So I just like to point out that Raisa will be in market mode, which means she is watching her coin purse extra carefully. She's
Alrighty.
Vigilant with her watching of people.
Good deal. Well, once you walk inside, all manner of aromas from blood to fruit to cooked, some kind of cooked something that you can't really make out what it is, fresh fish, all these different smells start accosting your nostrils. Glancing around, you can see a bunch of tables set up, everyone seemingly with a different array of merchandise. Not that many people in here actually shopping. More vendors, in fact, than actual customers. In the very far right-hand corner is a very well-dressed individual sitting behind a small desk with a pile of coins and some pieces of paper and a rough, middle-aged-looking swordsman standing at his side. Apparently there's cows in here as well.
Cattle's out back.
Yep. Hey, the meat that this guy is preparing over here is that fresh. It's still moving. There you go. In. Yep.
You pick. Oh, can't hear you.
I'm going to say they might have tuna to the right.
Shut Deer. Up.
Sushi.
The only thing that's really appealing to me is up in the northwest. I mean, northeast, armor and stuff. So I'm going to go that way.
I'm coming with you, sweetie pie.
I'm purposely going the opposite.
Okay. Alright. Alright, well, you get up here. I'm assuming you're paying attention to this table. Is that correct, Radovan?
Yes, that is correct.
All right, well, it's a kind of a fairly dirty-looking individual. Probably somebody in the smithing trade, by the looks of him, has a fairly decent arrangement of weapons laid out on this huge table, obviously for sale. This fellow with the green shirt is kind of looking through them and perusing them as he, you know, as you guys walk up towards him. Okay, Racer, the table you are at seems to be powders, little vials, all the sort of thing that make you go squee!
I knew it.
Alright, so Radovan and Kia, what are you guys up to?
Well, who's this guy in front of me?
Somebody perusing the weapons. He looks just like a guy looking for a fine purchase today.
I'm gonna saddle up beside him and say, ooh, look at these.
Oh, look at that one. Wow.
That one's a big one.
Then we party boy him.
Yep. Do I get a sense of their general quality of the smiths? I mean,
They look decent. I mean, you don't really have any smithing skill or whatever, but I mean, glancing at the, you've seen enough weapons to know that these are well forged.
Hello, guys.
They kind of look and, hello.
Crickets.
Nice weapons here.
The guy in the green shirt says, yeah, I'm in the market for a nice sharp sword myself.
Oh, what for?
Oh, it's getting a bit dangerous around here.
Yeah, I've heard.
I haven't heard, is it? We just got here.
Oh, dear.
Well, I'm sure you'll be safe if you stay inside the city limits. But, yeah, there was some nasty business off to the northeast.
Oh, dear, what happened?
Bunch of people were murdered in a local town. Butchered.
Murdered?
Murdered.
By who?
I don't know. Everyone's saying it's probably tribesmen.
Is that their only... idea? Tribesmen?
Well, what else would it be?
Well, any... Where would the corpses of the town... Would they be buried, or is there a cemetery nearby?
To pay our
or are
respects.
They just left to, you know... Left
Don't
to
know.
The sun?
Don't know anything about that, I'm afraid.
Would anyone in this town know?
Well, someone might, but who, I don't know.
Like local magistrate, or...
Well, the closest thing we have to a magistrate... Is the tradesmaster. That's him over there. And he points at this fellow in the fine grey robes. Of some form of weird office.
Is it okay.
That's basically our mayor, tradesmaster, and general judiciary should any discrepancies come up and decisions have to be ruled upon.
I'm gonna heft my Morningstar, the Renizen one, in front of the green guy, and I'm gonna say, if you want a real weapon, go with something like this.
Okay, he looks and goes, wow, that is quite splendid.
Does some it destroys stone and it pierces too. Can't go wrong. Swords are kinda.
Yeah, but what if something like that cost? You must have paid a pretty penny for that.
I paid about 25 gold.
Where on earth did you get something like that for so cheap?
Well, he didn't really know what
excuse
he
was me.
I'm not gonna actually say that, but I'm gonna say no. It cost a pretty penny.
All of these weapons here are of fine quality. If you're looking for a sharp sword and not a bludgeoning club like that, I recommend any one of these.
Well, my friend's privy to the quarterstaff. Another friend of mine loves the daggers.
He says, well, I've got a couple of daggers for sale. Don't have any quarterstaffs. Closest thing I've got to a bludgeoning instrument would be a military pick.
Well, that could do you well.
I thought there was no military around here.
Well, there isn't as such, but that's what it's called. Got a bastard sword for sale as well, but there's plenty of bastards about.
Oh! Hey! Isn't he funny, honey?
Does Raisa hear that?
Possibly, but it would be a far stretch. There's a lot of people between you and it.
Good.
Chit-chatting.
Well, honey, we should talk to the mayor.
Right. Meanwhile, over at the table of interesting alchemic items. Okay, so there's this fairly short little fellow sitting there, and he's in the process of carefully measuring drops of one liquid into a vial. And so as soon as he's squinting, so he kind of sees you come into vision, like, slightly blurred. He's like,
"Oh, excuse me. Can I help you with anything, my dear?"
Just browsing. What do you have to offer?
Oh, well, all kinds of tonics, tinctures. I've got some very interesting snuff. It really depends what you're looking for. Got some fine muscle rub. Sleep tonics, AIDS, eucalyptus.
I'm just looking.
Well, if you got any questions, just everything's labeled.
Okay.
So realistic, though. No, just looking.
Okay. Well, he's just hovering there, impatiently watching you.
Yeah, I'm just like literally reading every bottle, just looking.
All right. Okay.
Just more or less kind of trying to listen to all of the merchants in that circle, in like in this.
Okay.
So honestly, trying to make it look I'm looking. Right. And
they're not really talking to each other. It's pretty quiet, to be honest. They're all just more like looking anxious, waiting for, hoping that someone's going to come by their booth so they can sell something. But, you know, they're like eyeballing all the customers. The strange thing is, nobody is barking. Nobody is, like, shouting out their wares. Nobody is calling.
I hear barking.
That's a dog. okay, but yeah, nobody is, like, overly shouting out. Almost like there's some kind of decorum that they're following. Okay, so Radovan, you have gone over to the Trademaster's table.
Yes, on my wife's suggestion. And I'm going to just approach the table and... Hello. Good afternoon.
Hello.
My name is Radovan Rainier, and this is my wife, Kialana Rainier.
Oh, my God.
Kialana Rainier. Okay, yes.
I don't even know your wife's name.
Well, I'm going to obviously stumble because I'm not used to saying it ever. You know, like little throw-up in my mouth. Well,
welcome to the marketplace. Are you interested in leasing a stall?
Well, I am a prospective trader from Saramorn, far to the southwest.
Well, we have all manner of things being sold here, you know?
I see that, and it's quite a lovely selection. I guess the religious person in me has been worried about what's been transpiring to the northeast of here. And it started.
People seem to be talking about nothing else. Well, it's quite disturbing, you know. It's damaging our trade.
I understand that, and I follow Cuthbert, if you haven't noticed. You know, I'm going to show my belt buckle, my holy symbol.
Oh, okay, yes.
And I'm very concerned about the state of the corpses of the poor souls who got murdered. Like, did anyone go out there and collect them or bury them? I mean, have they been laid to rest in any respect?
I know that there was a dispatchment of King's Knights went to investigate. I feel sure that they would have probably taken care of the bodies.
Is there like a local cemetery or place where they would have been buried?
Honestly, around here, we burn most of the corpses and scatter the ashes. We consider it good luck. But I couldn't tell you for a starter. After all, how do you dispose of nearly 500 corpses?
Well, without the land becoming sick, I understand. It just troubles me.
Well, then go and investigate yourself.
I've heard the roads are quite dangerous.
I would have said till recently that the roads were quite safe, but there was a unpleasant situation about a week ago along the Eastern Road, yes.
So you would suggest we take the Northern Road?
Well, you can't really get to Astarden on the Northern Road. Well, you can, but you're going to go an awful long way away around your original idea of destination.
Thank you for that. As you know, if you do not know, we are new to this area.
So. I've never seen you before, and I never forget a face.
Well, then you know I speak the truth.
I just look at you. Awfully quiet in here, though.
Well, you see, we try to keep... Trade is very important. Rockhelm itself, the entire town, is funded by this very building here. We seem to make sure that we have a fair trade policy. People barking and shouting and competing and trying to entice customers isn't a good method of business. Not in an enclosed building like this. In an outdoor market, maybe, but in an enclosed establishment. Of course, the bonus is you don't get wet when you're shopping.
Fair. Interesting.
So, yes, one of our merchant conditions is that you can smile, you can wave, you can hold up merchandise to entice, but there is no street barking of your goods or merchandise here. It's not permitted.
Civil.
Quite.
Well, thank you, sir.
It's a civilized hub in a hostile land. That's how I like to think of it. I just must write that down.
Well, I haven't seen many guards protecting this place besides the walls. I mean...
Oh, well, I have a guard. This fellow right here, you see? And he taps him on the shoulder.
It's kind of amazing you guys have managed to survive for so long with these three tribes surrounding you.
Well, here's the key, you see? By not having any guards, there's no feel of threat. There's no feel of... emboding. Everybody here is welcome, even the tribesmen, as much as, quite honestly, it's not very pleasant when they do come. Most of them keep far enough away, but every great once in a while, some of them will be brave enough to come into town, usually to purchase weapons or rope or tools, as it were.
In any mass quantities, or are they
just...
Oh, no,
rarely, only in small groups. But and once a year, there's usually quite an influx for one day from the west, which of course is very welcome.
Yes, the Harrier tribe.
Harrier tribe, right? Yes.
It's
a festival day once a year.
When are they next due?
Oh, I'm afraid you've missed it for this year. You'll have to come back Midsummer's Eve next year.
That's a shame.
Especially for a virile man like yourself, I'm sure that they would be more than happy to offer all manner of things in trade.
Well, you see, we, my wife and I, had a paranoid friend to the south who seemed to think that it was a bad thing to even utter the name Harrier Tribe.
Definitely not around here.
Would it be... wrong to utter that name to anyone else? Maybe the other tribes, I can imagine.
Well, if you said anything to them, sexist or detrimental towards women, I wouldn't fancy for the length of time you'd keep your head upon your shoulders, but beyond that...
Well, they were rather unsavory outcasts in the tavern not a few hours ago, and they had a woman slave.
Oh, really?
It might be...
I'm all for trade, but I don't really... not really into the whole trading of life, as it were. Unless it's livestock.
Well, me neither, but...
Don't condone slavery, and I won't permit it here. There are no slavers here.
Well, they were in your tavern.
Well, the tavern, maybe, but not in my trade hall.
Okay, well... There was talk by some of the residents, or by some of the people in the bar, that the lady was of the Harrier tribe. And it was kind of troubling.
No, that would indeed be, especially if they were found here. Oh, we need to make... He kind of leaves everything. We need to make sure that that woman, whoever it is with the slave, we need to find reason to get them out of town. We don't want the Harriers hearing about this and coming to visit.
Well, apparently they traveled to the east, so they already left town. That's good, I was told by a friend.
Yes.
Still troubling all around. I wouldn't want any innocents to come between a tribal war, you know?
Well, no. With all the recent goings-on, there has been lots of rumors about unrest of the tribes. That's for sure.
Is there any person in the tribes that we could talk to peacefully, and how would we approach said people? Like the Hans Plains guys, I've heard that they are peaceful enough.
No, I wouldn't go as far as to say peaceful. I would say less hostile, more approachable, but still very suspicious.
So how would I go about...
I would recommend you don't, unless you take somebody that's more familiar with the tribesmen.
And is there anyone who's more familiar in town that we could talk to?
And he says, well, yes. Over there. And he points kind of directly behind you.
Oh, okay. So to this person. Or to this person. Is that Colum?
No. Well, okay. It's a trapper, yes. Somebody in that kind of, I mean, hence the fact that he's got a whole bunch of furs and stuff, but yeah. He says, okay. He doesn't seem to be too frightened of trading with the Harns tribe. He may be able to at least send you in the right direction.
And his name is?
Colum. No. He says, no. I don't know his second name. He says, but his first name is Ratus.
Ratus.
Ratus, yes.
Well, thank you very much, sir.
And Phantom, thank you for subscribing, dude. Hey. Very much appreciate it. Give that man some love and rollies.
Welcome. Take your pants off.
Take your pants off.
Kia, any questions for the sir?
No, none.
Okay, dear. Well,
it was a pleasure to meet you, Sir Radovan Rainier, and you, Kia Liani.
Kia Liana Rainier.
Oh, Kia Liana, I don't think that's what you said the first time.
Yes, it's quite the mouthful. Kia Liana Rainier.
Kia Liana Rainier, yes, I won't forget.
It's my favorite. I love my name.
It's my favorite.
So we're going to go here and basically look for Raisa, I imagine.
Okay. Well, meanwhile, Raisa is perusing the fish store.
Actually, in the amount of time that it took for that conversation, I should hopefully be done. No, I wanted to pick up if they had salmon at the fish place.
They do.
Pick up some of that, and then I was going to head over here. Is this fruit?
That is fresh fruit, yes. Fresh fruit and grab a actually, this one is vegetables, so this is all veg. This one is fruit.
Oh, okay. Then I would have gone over here.
Okay.
Picked up...
they've got melons, they've got bell peppers, they've got bananas, pears, nuts, apples.
A pear and some nuts. And
a pair of nuts?
Yes, a pair of nuts.
All right. Yeah. Okay, so knock off, I suppose, about 6 copper for all of that. All right.
All right, and I will meet up with...
them. The newlyweds. Alright, okay.
I'm going to gesture for Raisa to come over as I go to Ratus. this is Ratus, right? That's who we pointed to?
Nope, this guy.
The trapper. Trapper,
yes.
Okay, that's...
The guy with all the circles around him. Okay.
I just picked up some stuff from Marlo. I think I'd like to take it to her if you guys don't need me.
Yeah, she's... in the room, maybe get her some non-alcoholic drinks to sober her up.
Mm. And, which room?
Two. No, the room that I went into.
Yeah.
I know.
Two works, yeah.
Room 2. And I'm going to give the key. Set it up in there. We'll be with you in a second. When we wake her up, we'll all have a conversation. But I need to talk. We need to talk to this guy. So we'll be right behind you.
Perfect. We'll meet you in the end.
Okay, so Racer, you're heading back to the tavern. Okay, what are you two going to talk to this fellow about?
Sir Ratus, is it?
His name. Well, the guy said his name was Ratus, yeah.
So, hello, Ratus. My name is Radovan Rainier.
Okay, he looks at you. He looks like a reject from a Duck Dynasty video.
Oh, God.
He has a massive beard that is entirely unkempt and too long. He's too short to be Hagrid.
Sure, he looks at you.
And he says, Ratus.
Ratus.
As in rat and us. As in more than one rat.
Well, what a name that is. I want to give Kia a look. This is my wife, Kia Liana Rainier. How do you do today?
It's all right for some.
Well, I was hoping...
Hasty Fighter, thanks for the follow-up.
We could procure your services. Your help.
I'd rather you procure yourself some of my furs and skins.
Well, about that, I heard on good authority that you have done some trading with the people of the Hans Plains tribe.
I have, yes.
What would it take if you could help us establish relations with them?
Relations.
Money.
How much money?
Stop looking at us like that.
So expensive.
He's appraising you.
50 gold.
Damn. You think we have that much?
I know you've got that much.
Oh, how? If you don't mind me asking.
Well, you could sell that shield and at least raise 5 or 6 times that. And that armor that you're wearing. And that ornate stick that she's carrying. If you don't have it in coin, you have it in merchandise, that's for sure.
Not for sale.
Well, then I suggest you come 50, up with 50 gold.
50 gold is ample and fine. Pretty much we want to talk to them about Istardin. And about the going on.
For 50 gold, I will take you into their territory as safely as I can and teach you a little bit about their customs and maybe make an introduction for you.
And
then you're on your own.
For 50 gold, would you, if the gift is required as offering, would you also have that provided?
So you don't tell us. No, but I can tell you what you can give them. I can tell you the sort of gift that they would appreciate.
And then you just leave us up there. Is that my impression for 50 gold? You'd take us there, introduce us, and then just leave?
Pretty much.
What about safe passage back?
Well, I ain't necessarily promising that once I've made the introduction that there will be a passage back for you.
Well, if we only give you half the gold then and then half afterwards.
Well, I won't be taking you under those circumstances. It's 50 gold in advance. I will stick with my end of the bargain. I will take you through their territory and make an introduction.
While teaching some of the customs.
Exactly. And as I said, I'm more than happy to tell you what I recommend you take as a gift.
Oh, okay.
How about for 100 gold, you ensure our safe passage back? You stay with us throughout the entire endeavor.
If you immediately turn around and come straight back, yes.
What a fuck.
Well,
I ain't sticking around up there. It ain't good, safe territory, especially not at night. And the Harns folk are, while they are the least hostile of the tribes, they're not really the most friendly of folk. And quite honestly, a few of them are not fond of me, so I don't really want to be staying there too long.
Where do you live in town?
I don't live in town.
You have a shop here and you just leave in the evenings?
So I come here about once a month with my fresh furs, usually sell them, and I head back, go trapping again.
Where do you go trapping?
To the north. Follow the northern road to the edge of the mountains. Mountain lions, bears, that sort of stuff.
So you're here just for the day? Then you're gone.
Unless I don't do very well today, which
thus far it's been a bit slow, then I might crash at the inn and stay again tomorrow. But if I haven't, whatever I don't do, I never stay more than 2 days.
Okay, I'm going to reach into my pouch of coins and take a gold coin out and put it on the table and say, you're going to spend the night at the tavern because I would like to speak to you later. I have friends we need to talk to. Does that sound fair? Stays on me.
Unless I sell everything.
How much stuff is on his table?
There's a bear skin, what looks like some kind of mountain cat skin, some hides of something you're not entirely sure of. Okay. Looks like some kind of fox fur, and... You want to buy it all?
Well, no, if I do, he's going to leave. But I want to see... I'm trying to appraise the likelihood of him selling everything.
There's only 6 items left on the table. There's a fairly good chance.
For a gold coin, could you just spend the night for this deal of possibly earning 100 gold? Is it such an inconvenience?
It's not that it's an inconvenience. To be truthful with you, I don't really want to do it in the first place. But
I understand.
I can't really turn down that sort of money.
I look at Kia. I don't like this at all. I'm going to take my gold coin back, and I'm going to say, thank you, sir, for your information. Fair enough. We are staying at the inn. Hope you sell everything. Come on, let's go, Kia.
Well, if you want, I can at least... Yeah. I'll either be by the inn this evening to stay, or I'll be by the inn this evening to let you know I'm leaving town. How does that sound?
Sounds good. I'm in room 2.
Fair enough.
All right. Have a good day. Hope you sell everything.
All right. You're heading back to the tavern, so we're gonna just finish up there and wrap things up, and then we'll be out here. Okay. Let's see. So meanwhile, while you were discussing things with Rattus, Ratass, whatever you want to call him, over at the tavern, so Racer was, oh, come on, roll 20.
I love how Kia's there, too.
Right. Okay. Yep, so Racer, you're there, you're heading back to the tavern, what's your game plan?
Alright, I'm thinking these are the stairs here.
Yeah, they're the stairs going up.
So I'm going to go up to room 2, which I conveniently have the key for.
Okay.
And I'll just lightly knock before I open. Be like, Marlo, quiet, not too loud. I just don't want to startle her. But if she's not awake, I don't want to wake her.
She's probably in a fairly deep sleep with all that booze in her. Hadn't been that long.
Okay, well then I'm assuming there's probably a table and a chair in there somewhere.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So I'll just sit there and stare at her while she sleeps.
Do evil things.
No, I'll sit there and wait.
Okay, alright.
Actually, I'll probably tie up my hammock and sleep myself a little bit, maybe rest.
Okay, alright.
Hang out.
So about 20, 30 minutes later, Radovan and Kia show up.
Go in the room, see that Race is also kind of sleeping.
Yep, she's taking a nap.
I guess I'll just peruse the item she got.
Did you lay them on the table and stuff like that, or are they still in your backpack?
Oh, good question.
Yeah.
Yeah.
No, they're out. I put them out on the... I made them all nice. And
okay, so you laid them out as like...
Like a platter. So when she gets up, they can give it to her and if she wants it, or...
Yeah, so there's some salmon, there's some bananas, there's some nuts, there's a pear, and...
Well, I'll have some bananas and nuts, and I'll just sit down and
are you
wait.
Asking, or are you just taking?
I'm just taking.
That's not for you, fatto van!
Actually, yeah, I'm going to look at you and be like, really?
We'll get more food, she's sleeping.
Radovan, that's for Marlo.
We all get more food from downstairs.
Go downstairs and get it then, this is for her.
It is all going to be for her. Relax.
Radovan?
She's not even up yet.
Radovan.
Oh, my God. Go to sleep, woman. As I leave to get more food, I'm going to nudge her hammock so she sways a little bit.
Sleep.
Oh, that showed you. Oh, that showed her.
So I'm going to go down and get more fucking food.
I'm going to lock the door behind him so that he can't come back in. Girls club.
You know, honestly, getting out of that hammock is a difficult thing. So I don't think hammocks are a bitch to get out of.
Totally
trapped in it forever. Yeah. Okay, no, so yeah, you go downstairs and get a whole bunch of cooked food and stuff like that.
Go back upstairs, see that it's locked, knock on the door. Kia, are you going to let me in or no?
Dinner!
Are you going to be a jerk, rat of jerk?
No, I'm not. Let me in.
You're going to hear, just trying to get out of my hammock.
Kia opens the door.
Okay.
Thank you. Go to the spread, the table, put the new, fresh food. There's probably some bacon there, and I'm going to actually walk over to Marlo and put it under her nose. Smell.
Radovan, you promise.
Picks up and vomits on Radovan.
No, you don't. Come on.
I totally do.
She sleep vomits on you.
There's no way she can reach off the bed from where she's in the middle of the bed.
Projectile vomiting.
Not to be true. I don't mind. All right. I'll sit at the table and eat my bacon.
Hello, jerk.
Okay, then Marlo retracts her vomit.
Okay. Well, with all the noise and the commotion, Marlo is probably coming around right now. A little groggy, probably.
When I see that Marlo's coming around, I'm going to give Radovan a little smack on the shoulder, be like, idiot.
Marlo actually has proficiency with projectile vomiting, by the way.
+3. It comes with the robes, right?
Well, she's skilled at it. She already hit an archmage with it.
True. So.
Skills.
I'm just going to wait for Marlo to wait.
Okay. So, yep. Once you come fully round, you can see everyone leering at you from around the room. Upon the table is fresh fish and fresh fruit. And there's other cooked things, meats and stuff, that probably will make you go... In fact, if you ever want to get under Radovan's skin, all you have to do is pretend to vomit.
Yes. So if you, when Marlo, when you look at Raisa, you're going to see, like, concern. Like, are you okay?
Did something happen? And then she's going to recall...
Oh, yeah.
Are you okay, Marlo? Comfy?
Physically, I'm fine.
Yeah. Linen. Cotton. Comfort.
I got you some fresh food, if you can eat. I don't know if you can eat right now, but...
Thanks, Raisa.
Some water, too, for everybody.
Right, Marlo slowly starts to eat a little.
Slowly coming round.
Well, we are concerned about you. You before you fell asleep on the tabletop, you did flip us the bird. You remember
did
that?
I?
Yeah, kind of. Said we didn't understand you and we never would, and that we were jerks for impugning your honor. You know, stuff like that.
I understand where the reasoning came from. Just...
Okay, well, we know some things. While you slept it off, we know that the people that did that to you, that company of barbarians, basically. Not barbarians, but you get my gist. The tribesmen, they traveled along the Eastern Road. Raisa found that out. And, yeah, that's actually pretty much it. But we did want to talk to you about it. Do you have anything you want to ask or say?
It's not of concern.
Well, it is to us because you seem to claim that you can never go, you claimed you can never go home.
This is true, but we have a mission at hand that we should focus on.
True, but that's a serious charge you've stated. Can you really, like, I mean, you just can't go home because of your personal shame, or is it a law of your land that if you're dishonored, you can't return? I'm sorry.
They would not kick me out. They would not tell me to leave.
Would you feel obligated to tell them that such a thing happened to you?
I would not keep it from them.
I look at Raisa and Kia. Just kind of give it like a mini shrug. Like, what would it take for you to regain your honor? In your eyes.
I back down from a fight.
To save others.
It was in the moment. That moment will never be reclaimed.
But you saved others.
Did. Race is not wrong.
Merlin, thanks for the follow, bud. Or bud S, whichever.
In backing down from that fight, you possibly saved the lives of everyone in there.
Oops. Reacquire cams, folks. Cam on, cam off.
You do realize that, right, Marlo? That had you pursued the challenge, which you didn't even know was a challenge, the other people in the tavern could have been slaughtered or hurt.
And you're all so, back, good deal.
So you saved their lives by holding back.
This is a presumption.
But if we would have gotten into a fight, we would have drawn way unnecessary attention to ourselves, jeopardizing our mission and jeopardizing our lives. And that's
the fight was mine alone.
But you're not alone. You're with us three. We don't just stand idly by. Well, I mean, the Colosseum was an exception, I will grant you, but typically we would not allow you to be alone. You're not alone. You haven't been alone since we got you from Rorschach's little camp of fucking evilness. I give Kia a little look, like, sorry I had to say his name, but I did. Sorry. So,
I do not blame any of you for my being in this land is an agenda of my own that I have kept to myself. But henceforth, it is not something that you can understand, as I have not told you of my agenda. It is one that must stay my own.
Before, I'm going to interrupt you real quick, just because poor old Bill is fixing to go to bed, and he gave us our last donation, so I just want to read that real quick before he retires. Last one for the night, before I call it quits. Great roleplay all around. Rest in peace, Marlo's honor. Fuck Dire Bears. Again.
Thanks, Bill.
Appreciate it,
Bill.
Dude. Before he left us and thought we didn't acknowledge it, so thank you, dude.
I'm just gonna sigh. There are apparently many secrets to be had in this group. And I look around at everybody. I don't even think we, the three of us who have been together the longest, know everything there is to know about each other. And I know for a fact that some things are known by some people and not others in this group. So I don't judge you for wanting to keep your agenda to yourself.
It's not necessarily a want as much as it is a necessity.
But you don't follow a god, right?
I do not.
So you have no fear of, like, you know, godly wrath raining down upon you for violating his term or her terms.
For some of us, it is not all about pleasing a god or an otherworldly being. Marla realizes this could be a bitchy comment, but...
Well, she said it, so... Fair enough. I mean, I don't even think Kia fully understands what I have to go through, and I don't think I fully understand what Kia has to go through. I think that's fair all around, right? Look at Kia again.
You're right, Radovan. For once, good job.
Thanks, Kia.
I must restate, I do not blame any of you. I could have accepted this encounter despite the pleas for me not to. I chose not to reciprocate.
Well, you were kind of forced by our hands, so you could see why we might feel you are mad at us or blame us. We would have done everything in our power to stop that fight from... I would have done everything in that power to stop that.
It was your will. It was not mine. I chose not to fight by my own will.
Fair enough. Well, you made a smart decision. I will just say that outright. It was the right choice to not engage. That doesn't mean we're not going to engage after all. You do understand.
I do not follow.
Block Central, thanks for the follow, bud.
I'm going to look at Raisa. I'm just going to say, well, we don't want to jeopardize our mission and our purpose, but there is a chance that these guys that you back down from would cause war, for lack of a better word, if it is in fact what they had in their possession. It would seem that they, being outcasts of the Hans Plains tribe, wanted to join the Scarbloods, possibly having a hairier woman tribes member as a slave. There's a chance that this could be, all three tribes could be on the brink of some massive engagement with each other. And of course, from my perspective, that's not something I would let stand.
You would interfere.
To stop tribesmen from possibly slaying innocent people along the road that just happened to be within the territories? Yes, I would. Of course, that isn't our stated objective and our mission. So, I guess what Raisa and I spoke about, we'd want to say this to you to see what you would want to do if that was a part of what's been happening up here.
What I would want to do.
What would you want to do? And Kia, what would you want to do? And Raisa, I mean, it applies to everybody.
Marlo, I consider you a friend. When the three of us went on our adventure before, we made a promise to Kia that we would help her with something that was rooted deep in her soul. And we kept that promise, and in keeping that promise, we met you. I would extend the same promise to you as a friend, that once our mission is complete, I'll help you find these people, and if it helps you regain your honor, I will help you.
The only problem with that, Raisa, is what if that's too late?
I will at least extend the offer. And Marlo, I need you to know, I feel bad for what I did yesterday. And I understand the situation has put you in. But the consequences would have been far worse for our mission. But I don't know if we can fix the problem. But if we can, I'm willing to help you.
I appreciate the gift of friendship from you. I do. There is no way for me to explain what this means, that I have backed down from an encounter, from a challenge. And it may more than likely be something that cannot be reclaimed. But I accept this, and it is something I have to move past. It is not a concern of anyone but myself. I will continue to help. I will continue to extend my own hand in friendship. And the problem that this encounter or lack thereof creates is a problem that is mine and mine alone. It is something that I will deal with when the time comes.
Well, if that's how you truly feel, then I'm inclined to let you do that on your own if you wish, but just know that we are here to help you if you want it.
Thank you.
I'm going to get up and leave the room.
All right. Well, that's a pretty good place to stop things because we're way past. I just didn't want to break you guys in the middle of this big kind of emotional roleplay thing because if I do that, you'd never regain the momentum. I know how it is. So, I know Kia's got to get her butt out of here because she got to get up early. So we're going to let her go and we're going to go ahead and move on to a quick Q&A for you guys. And then we're going to wrap things up for tonight.
Yes, yes.
So, thanks for hanging out with us, Kia. We will see you Thursday. Juice Baker, really, thanks for the follow. Up,
so.
Sorry?
I'm going to leave it up so it doesn't go all wonky on you.
What?
Oh, okay. All right. Well, I'll just shut you anyway. Hi there. I'm Gorbad. Welcome to the Orc's Nest. I'm the Dungeon Master here on How We Roll, and if you'd like to follow me personally, you can do so on Twitter, at Gorbad. Check out thedmblog.com for all things Dungeon Master and Dungeons & Dragons related. And of course, you can follow me on twitch.tv/Gorbad. Also, guys, don't forget, to keep up with all things How We Roll, follow us on Twitter, at How We Roll. Check out the website, www.howweroll.com, and make sure you follow us on YouTube as well. Cheers, guys!
When I'm not playing Radovan Rainier, Cleric of St. Cuthbert for How We Roll, I'm just Shagget, a guy who can't do math in public. You can follow this poor lost soul on twitch.tv/Shagget, or on Twitter at @aneb_convos. For the love of all things boozy, stay in school.
I'm the Dragon Spooker, and I play Marlo the Hot-Blooded Monk for How We Roll. You can catch my Twitch channel at twitch.tv/thedragonspooker, or you can follow me on Twitter at @dragonspooker. I hope to see you guys around.
Hi guys, thanks for watching today's episode of How We Roll. I hope you had a lot of fun, and if you'd like, you can give me a follow at Twitter, YouTube, and Facebook at Bane Blackstar, or come say hi in my own Twitch channel at twitch.tv/bane1271. I stream full-time and usually play World of Warcraft, The Sims 4, and I even craft things out of polymer clay, but you never know what we'll get up to. I hope you'll come say hi, joining the conversation, and have some fun.
Hi, I'm Jane, and when I'm not fireballing innocent peasants, I'm perusing Twitter, eating ice cream, and petting my cat Norman. You can follow me on Twitch at Jane Ivana, and on Twitter at Jane on Twitch, and that's with a zero, not an L. Goodbye. Or as I say, peace, suckers.